13 different wide receivers were selected in the first three rounds of the 2019 NFL Draft. Lots to digest. But who are the top names for fantasy in 2019? So, of course, who we're going to bring in? Mike Clay, who does all of our dynasty rankings. You do our projections as well. So as you've crunched the numbers and looked at this, give me your top five wide receivers. You see all these guys here on the board below us. So tell me who your top five guys are for 2019 and redraft as you've crunched all the numbers.
Well, we're going to start out with Parris Campbell here. He goes from Ohio State to the Indianapolis Colts, and I think it's a great fit. He kind of reminds me of Randall Cobb in that, you know, last year his average depth of target was under 5 yards. He caught over 80% of his targets. He's very versatile, but he's a great fit because Andrew Luck loves to throw the ball in that short to intermediate area. So love the fit for Campbell in a high-scoring Colts offense. Would not surprise me if he jumps onto the flex radar at some point this season.
Caught 90 passes for the Buckeyes last season, over 1,000 yards, 12 touchdowns. Very effective as well. Again, a lot of competition for balls there. You've got both the tight ends in Ebron and Doyle. You've got Hilton, Devin Funchess they've signed as well. But yes, very talented player with an extremely talented quarterback on the turf in Indy. You mentioned the speed there. I agree with you, Parris Campbell. Really nice landing spot for him. Who's at number four?
All right, next up at four, I'm going to go with A.J. Brown, which, again, I think this could be a sneaky good landing spot. I know Tennessee loves to run the football, but A.J. Brown may be the best and most complete wide receiver in this class. So, again, the knock on him is kind of that he's not the fastest guy in the world.
Right.
But, again, short and intermediate area, that's where he's going to dominate. You're going to see him a lot inside, outside. He's very versatile. So, again, love the fit here. Would not surprise me if he's their number one receiver at some point during the 2019 season.
Well, listen, when I saw him, he was my favorite wide receiver coming out of college into this draft. So I kind of sad face emoji when I saw him going to Tennessee. I hated this landing spot for him. You said maybe kind of good. I get it in terms of the competition. We've got Adam Humphries coming in over from Tampa Bay in the slot there. You've got Corey Davis, who has yet to fulfill his potential in Tennessee. I'm just not a huge Marcus Mariota fan. As you mentioned, it is a run-first offense. You've got Davis and Humphries there. Having said that, A.J. Brown, 6 foot, 226. Two different years, consecutive years of at least 75 catches, at least 1,200 yards, at least six touchdowns at Ole Miss. A truly great player, great dynasty pick. We'll see if he can get fantasy production this year out of Tennessee. If they can't, it's on the Titans' fault, not A.J. Brown. Who's number three?
All right, next up, it's Marquise Brown. Speaking of
Browns,
talented wide receivers going to run heavy offenses, obviously he's really fast. He's dealt with that Liz Frank injury. You would think he'll be healthy in time for the season. And honestly, he might be the number one wide receiver for Baltimore. That's why he lands here. Why he's not number one? A super run-heavy Ravens offense, probably going to lead the NFL in rushing attempts this season. And also Lamar Jackson, we saw his accuracy struggles as a rookie. He could be better this season, sure, but again, with him running so much, it's really hard to count on.
I think I might flip these two. I get it with Marquise Brown, Hollywood Brown. Look, and we'll see, you know, they expect him to be healthy by the top of the season. Look, 5'9", 166, he's a small guy, but he can fly. I just think he's going to be a better real-life NFL player than consistent fantasy force because, at this moment, he is so much of the deep play when you think about sort of DeSean Jackson, if you will. Like, you know, just a guy that's the big play dependent, if you will, at least at this point in his very young career. So we'll see there, Hollywood Brown. But, yes, talented player, tough landing spot for fantasy value. It was a good pick by Baltimore. Who's number two?
All right, next up, the final two. We're actually going to talk about some good offenses
good.
Here. So let's go to N'Keal Harry in the last pick of the first round. He goes to the New England Patriots. And again, there was some knocks on him about his separation ability, his speed, but he's big, he's tough, he's going to be an asset near the goal line. And does he have an opportunity again in this Tom Brady and Bill Belichick led offense? They're really shaky at the wide receiver position, and some guy named Rob Gronkowski, may have heard of him, he retired. So big opportunity here for Harry. Could be an every down player as soon as week one, so like him a lot.
Yeah, especially when you think about Demaryius Thomas, who they signed, possibly starts the season injured, as you mentioned, coming up that serious injury. 6'2", 228, you mentioned the size. And you think about Demaryius Thomas and N'Keal Harry being signed, like, what are they looking for? They're looking for size. Like, we'll see what you get out of Austin Seferi and Jenkins here. But N'Keal Harry, who, by the way, one of the only Power 5 player, I love this stat, to have at least 70 catches and 8 receiving touchdowns each of the past two seasons. So certainly productive for Arizona State. Harry has probably the biggest combination of talent and opportunity on a good offense of all the rookies coming in.
Yeah, definitely. So that's Harry.
Who's number one?
Number one is another guy, again, in a high-scoring offense, a high-scoring offense last season, the Kansas City Chiefs. I'm going to go with Mecole Hardman. Kind of came out of nowhere to get drafted on day two of the draft this year, but this guy is extremely fast. He's extremely versatile. He could carry the ball. He could return the ball. He could be using bubble screens. He could go deep. He has 4.33 wheels. He's tough. He put up 17 bench reps he has it all in that regard in terms of that versatility. And again, he has Patrick Mahomes at quarterback and an opportunity to play a massive role, potentially opposite Sammy Watkins with Travis Kelce. There's other weapons there, but he could play a big role as a rookie. And with Mahomes under center, I mean, the sky's the limit here.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, listen, we talk about opportunity. We don't know what that opportunity is, as we still, as of this taping, we don't know what the future is of Tyreek Hill with the Kansas City Chiefs. But certainly there's potential for massive opportunities, you mentioned, with Hardman or not. But certainly a great landing spot when you land in an Andy Reid offense that's quarterbacked by Patrick Mahomes.
Yeah, keep in mind, they're a little weak with depth there. So either way, he could play a pretty big role.
Certainly. Yeah, certainly. Let's face it, right? I mean, it's not like Sammy Watkins is the healthiest guy around.
You got it.
Right? So there should be an opportunity to get on the field regardless of what happens with Tyreek Hill. One question for you, Mike, before you go. DK Metcalf wants a potential top 10 pick. Doesn't even make your top 5 rookies here. I mean, have you seen the shirt with him, the picture with his shirt off?
I have, but I've also seen him try to do them short area drills. Some concern about him generating a lot of volume in terms of, and that's big for PPR, right? If he's not going to catch a lot of balls, that's going to hurt you. He goes to a super run heavy Seattle Seahawks offense. I think you're going to see him running a lot of 9 routes and doing a lot of blocking on the perimeter as a rookie, regardless of whether or not Doug Baldwin's there. He's going to be kind of stuck, I think, in that vertical route. So maybe I have him at 33 catches as a rookie. Maybe he scores a handful of touchdowns. Maybe best is a DFS tournament option, not really a guy you feel comfortable starting in fantasy.
Appreciate it, Mike. Mike wrote a great live blog of the NFL draft, breaking down the fantasy prospects of every player in the first 3 rounds that you care about. Check that out on ESPN.com. Mike Clay, thank you very much.
Always fun. Thanks.
For more, sign up now for ESPN+.